Steve Bowers and
Cassandra Fuller.
Look here, she's back.
I did come back.
Welcome you to This Six in the City. You may have heard that I called you the Johnny Carson of daytime TV last week.
Oh, great. I'm not.
Well, because you were gone all the time. You
know, oh, like is Carson, that what it is?
Then some people said,
Don't be hating.
Then someone said, well, I don't really know who Johnny Carson is. I realize that's a generational thing.
It is.
You're not going to say
I do know
pretend.
Who he is.
All right, very good.
And he
took off a lot.
I didn't know that, but I do know who he is.
You know, like every other week, he took two or three days off. You know,
okay. Anyway.
She's back. It's good to have you had a good trip.
It's good.
Dinah Harris is going to be with us and Ernest Brooks the second. We're going to get an update on what's happening with the Jackson-Madison County Public Library. And then Winston Truitt will be with us. And we've got a special Indian artifact show coming up in September. We'll get details of that. Plus,
opening night of the Jackson Symphony is coming up September the 7th.
Is.
So Sherry Freeman's here to talk to us about it. And then Wendy Trice and James Theus are here because it's time for the
30th
annual African Street Festival.
It's coming up
August 30th
weekend.
Through September 1st.
Speaking of libraries, we're going to talk to Patrick Talley and Kelly Lim about what's happening at the Humboldt Public Library, and they got a special initiative up there, and we're going to get details of that. And then Diane Robinson is going to remind us that we're about to open the next season of the NED September the 6th. We're going to get a preview of that. Plus, Different Drum will be with us. We're talking about Rita Mack and Scott Myatt and Steve Short.
That's right.
And so that should
Different
be...
Drum.
Well, it should be an outstanding day.
Of course.
All right.
It always is.
Well,
when
it always
is it not?
Is. All right. You know,
anyway. We've got all kinds of things to cover.
Well, it's
an outstanding guest.
Yeah. It's good to have you back.
It's good to be back.
Can't believe I said that more than
heat.
Once, but I have.
You have.
Okay.
I know you miss me.
Yeah. Well, they're cute. Oh, it's time to go.
Oh, darn.
We'll be right back with more Six in the City.
For the most reliable drinking water supply at the highest quality, reach for the tap. Our tap water is safe and continues to exceed all government requirements. For more information about our drinking water, visit www.jacksenergy.com/JEACCR.
Hamilton was adopted from a rescue in 2008. He's quite the pug about town. He gets invited to a lot of parties.
He knows he's a pretty big deal. How could you not love him?
The JEA app. With it, you may view the electric outage map, report electric outages, receive electric outage alerts, view your current account information in real time. You can even make a payment with one click. Name, account number, you're in. Convenient access with the free JEA app, keeping you connected with JEA today.
Experience something new with ViewIt Video On Demand. Now you can preview and rent movies with your remote. Press the TiVo button to go to the home screen. Select ViewIt On Demand to get started. Browse new movie releases and events. Select what you want to watch, then rent. There's even free stuff. You'll find karaoke songs, fun screensaver for your TV, videos for the kids, and more. Experience more with TiVo and ViewIt Video On Demand.
Back to Six in the City. Dinah Harris is with us and Ernest Brooks II, who's a member of our Jackson City Council. And we're here to talk about special things going on at the library, the Jackson-Madison County Public Library, including time to get a library card if you don't have one.
Yes, sir.
All right, so what are we going to do? You teamed up with the councilman on this?
Yes, councilman.
Yes, Steve, this is our fifth year partnering with my city council office and the library. We believe every child needs a city, a library card.
Right?
And we think that that's the most important school supply that a child can have.
Okay, all right. So how do we go about doing this?
Okay, so on September the 3rd at 5 o'clock, we're going to have a big kickoff event. Okay. Councilman Brooks will be in charge of the program, and we have Angela Parks. She takes care of the refreshments and some of the other things with her book clubs. She has a little girls' book club called Butterflies and Bookworms.
Okay.
And a little boys' book club called Books and Bowties.
Okay.
And she works with children all year long to increase their literacy skills and all. So they'll be part of that, and there'll be activities for the kids and refreshments. And every child that signs up for a library card during the month of September will be entered in for a drawing for a free Kindle.
Oh, wow.
And so
wow.
We'll give one away to a little boy and one away to a little girl.
Okay.
But
September the 3rd, that'll be a Tuesday, right?
It's a Tuesday.
Tuesday evening from about 5 o'clock to 7.
What do they need to do to sign up for a library card?
Well, you know, you just come to the library or you can go online. But
you can get it online. Yeah. Right. Okay.
And we actually partner with the school system as well. They send forms home with the kids at school, and the parents can actually sign them and send them back to the school, because some parents just have a really hard time of trying to get to the library.
Right.
So we're trying to make it as easy as possible. And you can sign up online or you can come to the library. We do have to have some type of ID, something that shows you live in Madison
nice
County. And that's all. We're trying to make it as simple as possible.
Sure. And through my city council office as well, we've sent out those application forms to many of the churches and other youth groups, so they can get that information, and we hope that they would fill that application out.
Parents, grandparents, everybody,
and
guards,
bring
everybody
it,
make sure the insurance
sign. Because your library card is free. Yeah. It doesn't cost a thing.
It is free, that's right.
The other thing is now with tech, it gives you all the internet access. I remember we had an adult recently, a councilman that spoke about this, said, magazine subscribers not going to hear this, but say, I quit subscribing to magazine because I got a library card and realized I could get any magazine
at
the library.
That and e-books and, you know, a lot of people that jog and run, they listen to
the Book of the Month Club
there.
Is on the way out of business.
we
don't sell books anymore in Madison County. Everybody got a library card.
You know, they are still checking out a lot of physical books as well, though. We check out thousands of books a month, and about 20% of it is e-books. So there's still a large percentage of people that want to hold the paper in their hands.
I'm still that way. I still subscribe to newspapers.
Yeah,
and all
I have
stuff.
To read that
I
paper.
I have to read it.
Also, Steve, real quick, my fraternity, Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, is also one of our corporate sponsors, and they're very involved. This is one of their initiatives as well. Literacy, and especially early childhood literacy, which is one of my platforms.
Well, I appreciate what you're saying, and that's the best student aid and everything else a student can have, right?
It is these days, for sure.
And, you know, fines, sometimes people quit using the library because they accrue overdue fines, and we're trying to come up with some solutions for that.
Yeah.
And so several times a year we offer fine-free, and this will be one of those times. So if a child has books at home that are overdue and they just haven't returned them because there's a maximum and it gets up to, and at that point they're just like, I might as well keep the book.
Yeah.
Well, just return it, and we won't charge you anything.
All right,
you know,
that's good. I thought I told you last year I was still turning it. I was stacking music books.
One of those.
This one for the library.
One of your,
just bring them on back.
No wonder the burglar alarm goes off every time you get around there.
Right. Okay.
Now, we've got an author event coming up as well.
There is. I did want to mention that next Saturday, a week from this Saturday, September the 7th, from 10 to noon, we're going to have a showcase of local authors. And we already have quite a few signed up, but if there's anybody listening that has you live in this area and you would like to showcase your book, to contact us at the library and we'll make a space for you.
Very good. Next Saturday the 7th.
The 7th.
And what's that number at the library? So
You can call 425-8600.
Mm-hmm. The event the other night was wonderful.
Thank you. It was Elaine Christian. All the kudos to Elaine for that and the foundation. They did a great job.
It was a really nice evening and special event.
Yes, it was. Thank you.
Support our library.
Yes, absolutely. Library Foundation, Friends of, and everything associated with, because it changes lives.
Yes, it does.
I was a child in Burbank, California, and they don't even know I was ever alive, but that library made a big difference in my life. I was about 3 blocks away and could walk, and it changed my life.
Yes.
Yeah, it's good to see you both.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for having us.
We're going to be back with more as we continue 6 in the City.
With EPlus Broadband, you can work, play, chat, explore at the speed of light. Fiber technology delivers massive data to your home through strands of glass. HD video streams with no buffering. Websites load instantly, and games never lag, no matter how many devices are connected. Experience gigabit internet for less than $57 per month when you bundle TV and phone. Call or click eplusbroadband.com today.
The moment is fleeting. A brush with greatness. Genius at its peak. Catch it while you can. The best in baseball. One night a week. One place to watch. Sunday Night Baseball. All season long on ESPN.
Today.
Good.
I'm here to talk about how with technology you can make amazing worlds. Come with me. My team and I bring the Halo world to life.
Is that you? That is me. I wasn't a math genius, and I knew nothing about coding. But you guys do. You guys have the power to change things.
I want your job.
I want you to have my job.
Welcome back to Six in the City. We'll be hearing from different drum. They can use that name because they don't have one.
That's right.
So we'll find out.
March to the beat.
Oh, it's hidden out. Oh, that's the drum now. It's all computer programmed.
They march to the beat of a different drum.
Beat of a different drum. So we're going to get details of that coming up. We're delighted to have Winston Truitt on with us, and he's got a special show coming to Jackson, Tennessee next weekend, September 6th and 7th,
that
Friday and Saturday. Friday from noon till 7 and Saturday from 8 till 3. It'll be at the Carl Perkins Civic Center. And this is an artifact show. And you've got, you say, 80 different displays will be here?
Got 85 tables.
85 tables.
Will be here.
So we will see what then, Winston?
You will see, this is Native American artifacts, the original people here. You will see arrowheads. You'll see stonework. You'll see pottery. All of those will be displayed. You'll see some incredible things. There'll be pipes. It's free to the public. Free to the public. I'd encourage everybody to come and see. If you haven't ever been to an artifact show, they're great entertainment.
Winston, these artifacts then will date from what to what? What period to what period then?
That's a great question. We will have artifacts here that go back to what they call the paleo period, which is 10,000 years ago plus.
Okay.
So you think about, you know, the Egyptians or whomever having old things.
So we had civilizations here that far
back. Civilizations here. There were Native Americans here 10,000 years ago in this very area. They left some relics, some arrowheads, and you'll be able to see some of those. They go from that up to prehistoric, which prehistoric is pre-first contact with the Europeans that we're talking about. And there'll be...
And then we went through what ways? I mean, Pinson Mounds is...
Pinson Mounds, yes.
Is a couple thousand years old?
That's right. They're in the what's called a woodland area, is a couple of thousand plus years ago. And if you've been to Pinson, you'll notice there's several artifacts there.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
There'll be pottery here. Most of the pottery is either woodland or Mississippian, which is the most current period.
So it will cover what area geographically? The Mid-South, all of Tennessee?
It will cover basically the Mid-South and Midwest. We'll have dealers and collectors from Oklahoma, Arkansas, Kentucky, Mississippi, Alabama, East Tennessee, I think some for Ohio, Indiana. They'll be all around. And like I say, there will be some incredibly
This is the first time we've had this show, right?
It's the first time we've had this show. This was the old Nashville show.
Okay.
They've had this show in Nashville for a number of years, and costs, as you know, in Nashville have gotten kind of expensive. So we were fortunate enough to get them to come to Jackson.
Well, that's great. I hope they enjoy Jackson. I hope it works here. All right. So these dealers come from all over the country then?
They come from all over the country. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm.
So it's free to attend. There are things you could buy if you're trying to collect.
Yes. You can purchase Indian artifacts. You can
trade. Do they
talk
to you about the history of these things and all that with these?
Yes, these people love to talk about their artifacts. Right. You know, they're
going to a car show.
They want to share
about the car.
Exactly.
Okay.
The same thing. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes, there is a whole group of shows that are around the area, but just none in Jackson until now. So,
you know, the amazing, I guess, and disappointing, I guess, when we began settling here in the early 1800s, we just totally ran those cultures out. I mean, they just...
That is correct.
I mean, there's nothing left. Tennessee, the name Tennessee, a few things, but I mean, there's just no semblance of those civilizations at all.
Yes, there are people that go out in the fields and they look for these arrowheads. I did years ago when my dad...
Do you still find them?
You can, yes. You can? Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes.
You know, you'd think after a while...
They'd all be gone.
You would think that you'd already found them all, but no. There are people out there finding arrowheads every day. In the fields or the creeks.
Do they keep them personally? Do they go to museums now? Or what? The laws have changed down through the years.
They have. You have to have a permit to look on land. As long as the landowner gives you permission to go look on his land, then you can go look and find any arrowheads that, that are there. Now, you can't do that at the river. That's federal land.
Right. Okay.
Rules are different. Okay. Yeah, you can't do that by federal law.
Well, it's an artifact show. It will be absolutely free to attend.
It's first time
a rare
in Jackson.
Opportunity, and I hope that we'll do well in Jackson. It's Friday, September the 6th from noon till 7, and then Saturday, September the 7th from 8 a.m. till 3 p.m. Don't miss this.
And again, it's
at the Carl
free.
Perkins Civic Center, so it's free to attend.
Open to the public.
Winston, thanks for bringing this to this city. I hope it does well. I think
thank you for having me. We're excited.
An exciting addition to this city, and it's just, like I said, those cultures just totally disappeared. We moved in black and white into this area, started raising cotton and ran them off.
Right. Yes.
And so it's just a different part of our history. It's good to see.
It is good
appreciate
to see
you very much. Mm-hmm. Well, we're thrilled to have these folks with us, and we're going to do a Studio 6 with them. They go by the name Different Drum, and I said there wasn't one, but they've got one on computer.
That's right.
That's why we
Rita
walked
has
to the
it.
Beat of Different Drum. Rita Mack, Scott Myatt, Steve Short, this is Different Drum.
3, 4.
EPlus broadband customer. Want fast internet and Wi-Fi to power all those streaming devices everywhere in your home? You got it. TV that fits your family? You got it. Reliable home phone with the security of 911 emergency location? You got it. That's right. With internet, TV, and phone from EPlus broadband, you've got it all from one local company that cares. Call today for gig internet for less than $57 per month when you bundle TV and phone.
The process is called lining. Instead of replacing sewer pipe, you line it. The lining seals the pipe, covering any leakage points. This recent lining of the 54-inch River Interceptor line cost over $900,000, but that's much less expensive than replacement, and it extended the life of the key line that transfers sewage from several lines to the wastewater treatment plant on Miller Drive. Protecting community health and doing it efficiently is all a part of JEA Today.
I'm Mark Taylor. I'm the owner of Renew Biomedical Services based out of here in Jackson, Tennessee. We're a provider of
biomedical services for medical professionals. At Renew Biomedical, our use of telecom is of utmost importance. We have to reach our customers in a timely fashion so we can diagnose and service their equipment needs. So EPlus Broadband allows Renew Biomedical to connect effectively with our customers in whichever way they choose, via email, phone, Skype, teleconferencing, in any way you can imagine.
Good explanation of the difference. You know, not that we're a low-budget operation, but they just beat on that thing. It's not electronic.
It's
not anything.
It's called a different
drum. When Delaney Bonnie and friend did In Every Ending Love for You, they had a briefcase that they beat on because they were out of money, right? You remember that? So there we go. Anyway, we'll be back to different drum.
She didn't want to bring her briefcase.
I tell people all the time that I'd rather be in the Beach River Bottom with a toothache than have to run the Jackson Symphony.
There are days.
Is that the Country Club? I mean, two most challenging jobs in this community. We're delighted to have this lady with us because she's not only the director of the Jackson Symphony, she is absolutely doing a magnificent job. And it's Sherry Freeman. It's good to see you.
Thank you so much. And, great to be here.
Yeah, and we're excited. This season is the
59.
Next year is going to be the 60th, so get ready.
Have a big party next year.
Birthday year.
That's right.
Let's take his plane off and get started. The symphony is right around the corner. September the 7th.
September the 7th.
Saturday.
We will be opening night. For the 59th season.
All right, so we're going to be at the First Baptist Church?
This one will be at First Baptist Church. We're starting with the Masterworks, and so it's a beautiful night, and we're so excited to have a guest pianist with us.
Okay.
I mean, just an international renowned pianist, Vanya Lynn, and she is just going to offer an amazing concert with a full orchestra. So it's just going to be a beautiful night.
They added to the staging of First Baptist and also the whole, I mean, this is a big orchestra that comes in here.
Yes, it's a big orchestra. This is a big night.
Good stuff,
and First Baptist has a concert Steinway grand piano. So, I mean, no one will go home disappointed.
I'm just telling you, it is going
to be a fabulous night. And this is a wonderful thing.
7:30, that Saturday night, the 7th. You can still get tickets at
427-6440
or thejacksonsymphony.org.
That's right, $35 for all tickets.
All tickets.
So we're excited to kick this season off.
It will not make Sherry angry at all if you buy an entire season of tickets.
It will not. It will excite me.
So those are still for sale. And then we'll be back coming up with the first Pops concert will be the Starlight Symphony?
Well, yes, the Starlight
Symphony. The
28th of this month.
So we got stuff lined up.
I believe it's time already for the Starlight Symphony.
I know. It is. And, you know, I'll be back to talk all about that. But we are so excited, you know, to offer the 41st Starlight Symphony.
41st. Okay, well, that's amazing in and of itself.
So what are you telling people about the symphony, Sherry? I mean, you're out, you talk to people about supporting it, sponsoring it, getting involved with
Absolutely. I just want people to understand what they have in the city of Jackson. I mean, this is just a jewel. It is 59 years. You very rarely find symphonies, you know, in communities our size. But, you know, this is just a wonderful, wonderful symphony, a fabulous orchestra, and you just need to experience this. You need to take advantage of the arts and the cultures. And, you know, I was just sitting here listening to all the wonderful things that are going on in the community.
City, right, yeah.
Just be a part. Yeah. Be a part of the community and be a part of the Jackson Symphony.
Okay, all right. Well, the season will start on the 7th of September.
September 7th.
And the 20th. And we're heading toward the Christmas pops. Basically, will be at least one concert a month, right, during the season.
Right, right. There'll be pops.
We've got Valentine and, pops
right,
and all the stuff.
That's right. There are four pops this year, October, December, February, and April, then three classic works in September, November, and May.
Okay.
So just a wonderful year.
Are this pianist is coming in, you know, what is the background of this performer?
Well, she's Juilliard trained.
Okay.
I mean, just a magnificent pianist. And so it will be an exciting night. And, Steve, I would like to mention one thing. We have a full youth orchestra with the Jackson Symphony, which is just a wonderful opportunity. And if you have a young person that is interested, please give us a call.
Okay.
We'd love for them to participate in the youth orchestra. But the other thing we're doing in order to raise money for that youth orchestra, if you have any old instruments laying around your house, you know somebody wanted to play it one time, and if you donate those to the Jackson Symphony, we sell those back, and the proceeds go to our youth orchestra. And so we are glad to take those things off your hand and out of your attic. And, you know, like I said, you know, my son wanted to play the oboe for exactly 2 years. So, you
know.
It's amazing how much we aspire to all that, and somehow
right.
that goes away.
That's
in this
right. It just goes
but
away.
We, you know, we're very committed to that youth program, and we would love to have the support on
it's,
that.
It's also an important thing because music programs have struggled. I mean, you know, we talk about used to, like with JCM Band, Northside, Southside, they covered the football field. You know, band programs struggle and
that's
get those
right.
opportunities.
Well,
and it's just changed. Time commitments, everything else has changed.
That's right.
The orchestra could be an alternative for children.
That's right. It can, and our young people that are in that are amazing, and they oftentimes go on to, you know, to scholarships in college.
Right.
But three of them sit in our orchestra right now.
Oh, is that
that
right?
came
wow.
through our youth
wow.
orchestra.
Okay.
So
well, that's exciting.
It is.
Well,
great.
It's the 59th year for the Jackson Symphony. It's been an amazing commitment of people that started this back in the early 60s, and I
great
guess at Jackson Junior High School is
right.
where I guess they
it
performed
did.
There before the Civic Center was here. We have a splendid facility with the Civic Center and First Baptist Church, and these are great programs. We hope you'll avail yourself of that opportunity. September the 7th at 7:30, 6:45 pre-concert.
Pre-concert,
is that right?
Talk at 6:45,
okay.
and then the concert
so
begins at 7:30.
Explain the works and everything else. If we don't follow classical music, and not all of us do, and so it's a great opportunity.
It is.
It's good to see you. If you want to sponsor the symphony or anything, just talk to Sherry and them. They sell you program ads or
TheJacksonSymphony.org.
You better believe it. You know. We will get you involved.
Get involved in symphony.
One way or the other,
that's
right?
That's right.
And turn those band instruments in there, cluttering up the place. It's good to see you, Sherry.
Thank you.
I'm glad you're
Sherry.
There. Appreciate the work you're doing. We're going back to the main stage, and here they are once again. This is Rita Mack, Scott Myatt, and Steve Short. Different drum.
Yellow Mountain, on a cold flat land she rides, on a pony she named Wildfire, with a whirlwind by her side, on a cold Nebraska night.
Wildfire.
Throughout its history, Jackson, Tennessee has been a leader in manufacturing, education, transportation, utility service, and more. But the key to Jackson's future, full gig fiber to the home infrastructure, EPlus broadband. Innovative applications, fastest connectivity, revolutionizing everything. JA's fiber network offers Jackson unlimited capacity for any future bandwidth demands. Connectivity, heavy internet usage, the best reliability. Jackson, Tennessee, not just a gig city, an innovation city.
Stop and think about your health. Don't smoke. If you do, quit. Eat healthy. Make small changes in your diet that can impact your health. Be more active. Start in small ways and keep going. And know your numbers. Your blood pressure and your cholesterol are important to your health. Friends of Heart ask you be a friend of your own heart.
Jackson's first private utility was the Citizens Gas Light Company. The company organized June 28, 1871 to bring streetlights to Jackson. The system used coal or coke burned in ovens to generate gas distributed through wood pipes to streetlights ignited by lamplighters at dusk. From there, the service expanded to home lighting. We didn't know it then, but we were on the way to JEA today.
Back to Six in the City. Wendy Trice and James Theus are with us, and we're here to talk about the 30th annual African Street Festival. And none of us wanted to admit that we were here when that thing started. You know, I don't look a bit different than I did 30 years ago when we started talking about this. None of us do. James Theus is an answered prayer, and just couldn't see. He was seriously injured, a Good Samaritan accident. He was helping someone on the roadside, car had broken down and got hit, and thought we had lost you. A lot of prayer and everything else, just couldn't see.
That's why I'm here.
Yes, sir. Glad to see you. Appreciate it very much. Prayer works.
It absolutely does.
All right, so we're ready to go with the 30th. Where are we going to be this year?
We are at Omen Arena.
Omen Arena.
179 Lane Avenue.
Okay, all right. So we're
going to
set up.
Second year.
All right. Set up outside three days?
Yes, right outside of Omen Arena.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And that's Friday, coming up this Friday, the
30th.
31st, and 1st. Right. Okay, here we go. All right, so where do I need to be Friday?
Friday.
Yeah.
We are opening at 6 p.m.
Okay.
And we go until about 11 at night. And each day from on Saturday, we start at 9 and we finish up at 11. And on Sunday, 11 to 11.
Okay.
I think we have the only event that's 3 days of festival fun and entertainment for everyone.
Everybody. So everybody of any age will find something that works for them.
Absolutely.
So what all will we see, folks, this year?
Well, we're going to have African drums, of course, African dancers. We have a lot of local entertainment that we're so glad to feature our local artists.
Okay.
Because as we talked about years back when the festival started, we only had a festival DJ and everybody danced and sang and with the DJ. And we have our DJ, that our very first DJ started with us, back with us
this year.
That's DJ Blue, David Smith.
David Smith. That was the T.R. White Sportsplex, if I remember right.
T.R. White Sportsplex, yes. Man. This is our fourth move.
Okay. All right, well, this keeps working its way. Now, when do we need money and not need money? And there'll be food there, right? Food vendors and all kinds of things, right?
You will not need any money on Friday.
Okay.
We have established a free Friday.
Okay, excellent. And hold that mic up, Ms. Theus, if you will.
I'm sorry.
Yes, that's all right.
Like
I can hear.
Used to this,
I can hear, but nobody else can.
But yes, Friday is free for all participants. This is the first time we've done that, and we want to kind of give back after 30 years.
Right.
The community has supported us, and we want to do something to support them. Free Friday is just one of the things that we'll be offering. There'll be other things during the course of the festival that we'll be offering our participants that have been with us so long.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then Saturday, and then Sunday's still Gospel Day, is that right?
Sunday, we start off with Church on the Street with Pastor Shimon Scales and the Zion family. Okay. We go into the Gospel Explosion. We have host Tequila Jr., E.J. Shelton, and Dr. Frank Thomas will be in a lot of gospel greats.
Okay. Okay.
That regional in the region, and we have a little A band, a new band, actually from Paducah, Kentucky, called Gumbo and Grits.
Okay.
We have Just Friends Trio from here in Jackson.
All right.
And, of course, we have the Sankofa Drum and Dance Company out of Nashville. And we end the night with the Higher Ground Band from Nashville.
So it's a full evening of entertainment all Friday,
it's
Saturday, and Sunday.
It's action-packed, Steve. I mean, we keep the stage pumping all the time.
Now, what kind of foods are we going to find there?
Oh, a little bit of everything.
Everything.
Some soul food, the type carnival type food.
Okay.
And
African food?
Caribbean food, yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes. So.
So we'll have all that going on, fashions and a lot of there are other
fashion
vendors.
Shows on Sunday. Saturday, we have a LJ Country Soul Review, the Fifth Degree Band. We have a little reggae with Rude Ragamuffin out of Nashville.
Okay.
And we have our youth participating on Saturday. We have a learning hut, a game truck for the kids.
We just got it all. We've just got it all. I mean, 30 years, Friday, all the way to Camp Out. Can we bring
Home
a team?
Starting Friday, we start Friday evening at 6.
Friday at 6.
And then Saturday, we start at 11.
Start at 9 with D180 Fitness Workout.
So 9 o'clock Saturday morning, then we start 11 on Sunday.
Then 11 to 11.
11 to 11.
It will be this coming Friday, Saturday, Sunday, the 30th, the 31st, and September the 1st. It's the 30th African Street Festival, and these folks have been, Wendy Trice and James Theus have been with us from the very beginning.
That's
congratulations
right.
on the success.
Thank you.
It's wonderful.
Appreciate you having us.
For all of us still being here.
And thank you for your support.
Yeah, well, absolutely. It's always good to see you. Appreciate you very much. Appreciate
thank
you all
so much.
That you do. It's good
here.
To have you here. We'll be back with more as we continue Six in the City.
Where is the American spirit? It's right here, in the people of West Tennessee. Every day, people walk through these doors to selflessly help others, to give without expecting anything in return. So where is the American spirit? It's right here, in the people of Lifeline, our community's blood bank, where we all come together to help each other, and the American spirit thrives.
Ask what you can do for your country.
JA's Customer Center on Martin Luther King Jr. Drive now has a drive-through payment kiosk. No more getting out of the car, waiting in teller lines to pay your utility bill. The separate entrance allows for easy access, and the covered kiosk and step-by-step screen prompts guide you through the payment process. Cash, check, credit, or debit card. Credit to your account is immediate. A printed confirmation receipt is provided. Another step in service to customers, all a part of JA Today.
Tune to the Travel Channel. Say it, watch it. It's that easy with the power of voice control. Set up One Pass for the Warriors. Catch all the action with the power of voice control.
Patrick Talley and Kelly Lim are with us, and they are with a literacy program out of Humboldt that's being done through the Humboldt Public Library. And they're looking not only for people to participate, but also for people to help with this literacy program. So what is up with this? How's this program started, or is it already in existence, or is it just beginning? Or
it's in the beginning phase.
So brand new.
Yes, sir. This is a brand new literacy program in Humboldt called the Literacy Council of Humboldt. And it's birthed just to make sure that adults, and it's for adults. It's
for adults.
Literacy program. They do have some youth programs in Humboldt, but this one's specifically for adults in the area looking to advance on their speaking, to advance on their reading skills as
is
well.
Is it open to anyone in this area that wants to participate in this?
Any
adult then
any
participate
adult.
From anywhere in West
Even though State. It's starting in Humboldt, it's for Humboldt, Gibson County, and surrounding counties.
So if you're in this situation, we had some literacy programs here years ago and some with Tennessee College of Applied Technology, but it's a challenge in life, and a lot of people disguise it well that they're not able to read. But if you're in that situation, so this is an opportunity.
It's a great opportunity.
You're also looking for people to help instruct in this program?
Sir.
Okay. So what do we need to do to be a volunteer to help?
To be a volunteer, you can contact the Humboldt Library Okay. Then we actually have applications for both people who want to be a part of the program to actually advance in literacy and also who want to volunteer. You both go to the library, can contact the library, and they have applications for both applicants who want to volunteer or who also wants to go through the program.
Do volunteers need to have any qualifications?
Here it says the only qualification is that they have to be 18 years of age.
Okay.
They have to have a GED or have a high school diploma and just be willing just to participate.
Some people read some, but then the skills are limited. Is it designed for everybody that needs help reading?
Yes, sir.
Is that what we're after?
Yes, sir.
With this? Okay, all right. So, Kelly, what is your involvement with this?
I actually go to the Humboldt Library quite often, and I just wanted to volunteer.
So you're volunteering for this, okay.
And ask them what programs they have, and so.
How did it get started through the library then?
It got started through the library. There is a woman who connected with the library, and Joshua, who's one of the who works with the library, they've always wanted an initiative to make sure they reach out. And they actually have some figures about literacy. And it's something that they actually told me because I connected the same way Ms. Kelly did as a volunteer. And I heard a lot of the information, and they want me to get more involved. Just some of the statistics that says 32 million adults cannot read in the U.S. 21% of U.S. adults read below the fifth grade level. 19% of high school graduates cannot read. 85% of juveniles who interact with the juvenile court system are considered illiterate. 70% of inmates in prisons cannot read above the fourth grade level. So just some of the information that they gave, it just made me want to be more involved. So they had this information. I mean, one of the persons who's founded the program has done this before, and she's an advocate for literacy. And she just wanted to make sure that she connected this program to Humboldt.
Okay. The number at the library, 731, is 784-2383, right?
Yes,
that's
sir.
Right. 784-2383. Two things. If you're in need of this assistance in your life, the one way to take care of it, and if you could volunteer to help with this program because it involves people from across West Tennessee. Never will forget interviewing a plant manager years ago in West Tennessee that had people that suddenly were quitting. They had been working with him 20, 25 years, and he couldn't figure out what was happening. And what was happening, these people were skilled employees. They were changing production line, and they started handing out material to describe what was going to be happening, is how they were going to change production. And he didn't know that
they
couldn't read. And he was, and so he started a literacy program in the plant, to say, no, come on back to work. We'll figure this out. Or we'll show. We got other ways of communicating. But it stunned him to know that he'd had skilled long-term employees that had been working with him all this time, and he didn't realize that they weren't able to read. And so it's a pronounced challenge for those that go through it. And there are ways to get out of this. Appreciate y'all doing this.
It's a great program.
To know about this program. And has it started, or when will it start officially?
It has started officially.
Okay, but you can join in.
Yes, sir.
Still can. Okay. 784-2383. That's the Humboldt Public Library number.
And for those people who don't know, where's the Humboldt Public Library located?
It's located at 115 South 16th Avenue in Humboldt, Tennessee.
Okay.
Google
16th. That one up.
That's right.
MapQuest that thing, we're there. It's good to have you both here.
It is. Thank you guys for being
here. Appreciate
y'all
doing this very, very much. Well, we're going back to the main stage. I finally figured out all the instrumentation now.
You did. I think you've got it. I'm not so sure.
We welcome back once again, different drum.
They were Here at the Emergency Operations Center, we rely on EPlus broadband fiber network to better serve Madison County. With high-speed internet, we track storms and natural disasters in real time. Also, fiber internet gives us the speed to host training classes preparing responders from all over the county and state. The phone system allows us flexibility to stay in contact and make conference calls with both in and out of the office with local, state, and federal agencies. Connectivity is an important part of emergency management.
So, I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys, and then she hides them in that basket by the door. You know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket again. It's like, hello, that's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide-and-go-seek.
With EPlus broadband and watch TV everywhere, you can now take your TV on the go. Just visit watchtveverywhere.com to sign up. Then you're all set to catch your favorite shows, movies, and sports wherever and whenever you want on any internet-connected device. Choose from our growing selection of networks from your cable package at no extra charge. Visit watchtveverywhere.com to learn more. It's easy to sign up for EPlus broadband's TV everywhere.
Diane Robinson is with us because we're about to launch the next season of The Ned.
That's
How are you
right.
doing?
I'm good. I'm
September
ready.
September the 6th
September
is the
6th,
day.
Right around the corner.
That'll be next Friday night as we're doing the show. September the 6th.
We'll September 6th.
Maureen McGovern.
7:30.
7:30. Yep. All right.
Well, tell us about Maureen.
Okay. She's not the hottest thing right now, but she's been hot. And
there's got to be a morning after is what I think of.
The morning after, right. That was Poseidon Adventure, but she's right. also done music from other shows like Superman and the Tiring Inferno, and okay. she's got big numbers in those okay. as well. I think when people come, they're going to
recognize.
I don't know
music.
What all the songs she's going to sing, but a lot of them sounded familiar when I read through them. So I think right. it's Please like 60s, 70s mm-hmm. type.
So what
music.
Style show is this?
Yeah. Well, it's more like 60s or 60s, 70s. So
right.
it's
okay.
probably a little more like oldie. I'm not old.
Be careful now.
I know, right?
I don't know what she's talking about.
I saw that cut of the eyes and the shift of the body here. I read that body language.
I know. I was trying not to do that. Uh-huh. So, no, but her music's really good. I really think anybody will enjoy it. And, I mean, I think the younger group are going to recognize it from the movies, and then some of us more my age are going to remember from hearing her. But she's also been on Broadway. She's been in
Sorry, I mean, this
like,
is a
Little
very
Women
diverse
and,
career.
Yeah.
That she
yeah.
Has.
Yeah. She's
the title of the show is Long and Winding Road, which means?
Right. So I think she's really going through the music, like, from her history, you know, okay. like her history.
Start to her.
Yes. And she's got, I mean, she's got a, remember the song You Raise Me Up? I think that's going to be one I'm in there. So that was a little more new. So,
okay.
yeah.
I mean, yeah. So I think she's just got all kind. I think everybody's going to love her. I do.
Okay. Maureen McGovern's going to be here September the 6th. That's a Friday night to launch the next Ned season. Tickets are available at
425-8397.
425-8397. Can you get them on Facebook or a web page?
You can. You can go on the website. There's some extra fees if you do that. It'd be better just to call our phone number.
Can you get them at the door?
Or do you can, yes.
It's best to have them in advance.
Yeah. It's best to get them in advance, but yes, you'll be able to get her.
425-8397. That cuts out the processing fees or some
right.
of the processing
well,
fees.
Well, no, there's still some but not as much as if you do it online. Yeah.
Okay, very good. All right, so just call
It's
up.
Always more online.
You put them at will call? Is that what you do?
We do.
Okay.
Yes.
All right, great.
Or if they prefer, well, it's getting really close now. We were mailing them, but now it's kind of getting close.
Yeah.
And the way the mail runs, we'll
probably
just keep them at will call.
Will call. Okay, so Maureen McGovern coming in. That will launch the season. Then our next show will be?
The Cleverleys. And that one, I think I told y'all last time, they are... they sell tickets every day. I mean, like, every day.
That's
I just don't know that there's going to be any left
okay.
on the day of the show.
What makes them special?
Is it
they
comedy?
Can take any genre music, and they put it to burlesque some kind of way, and they're silly and fun and kind of hillbilly-ish. Redneck, more redneck.
Redneck.
Not hillbilly, more redneck.
Redneck.
And but as far as musicians, they are outstanding. I mean, you just won't find better musicians. They're just fun.
They must have been. Have they been here before?
They have not been
they
here.
They have not
before.
Been here. So people just know about them or buying the tickets.
Right.
Okay.
I don't know. People just knew
word
who they
spreading.
Were better than I did.
So they will be here.
They're going to be here. Let me look because okay. I don't want to tell you wrong. October the 24th.
October the 24th.
Yes.
And tickets are selling every day for that.
Yeah, there won't be any. I just really think there won't be any at the door for that one.
All right, so that gets us through October. So what are we going to do in November, December?
In December, we're bringing the Diamonds. And probably okay. everybody remembers Little Darling.
Oh, yeah, Little Darling.
Right, right.
Yeah.
But they're going to do some of their hits, but then they're also going to do
Christmas show.
Christmas
right.
music, yes. Okay. And they're really, I don't, and somebody asked me today, are any original? I think maybe one, but there might be two. I'm not sure.
There's a gentleman that I met that has a boat up, that keeps up at Cuba Landing that used to manage the New England Sea. And they had two different touring groups at one time. And he
oh,
was
really?
Part of one of those groups. But yeah, but he said the one that's coming here has got one of the original
I
members.
I think that's what I was told.
I mean,
but
yeah.
Maybe not hold me to that. But
yeah. Well, that's what I understand talking to him. And he had done some work
They're
with
really yeah. good. Yeah. You need to come here.
It's great opportunity great fun, to so. Hear them.
Now, that will be oldies music. You
yes.
can safely say that.
She hesitated on that.
I hesitated because I don't know about all this stuff. The Christmas music won't be so old.
No.
No, well, some of it will
Christmas
be.
Well,
okay,
it'll be
so
old, but
some of
it's recognizable. All of it's
middle-aged
recognizable.
Hymns, you know what I mean? Anyway, let me just have okay. this. Di's going to be back. We'll
don't
catch
get
up.
Her in her hole yeah. now. You
can
crawl out.
You can still get season tickets if you want them.
Yes, until the very first show.
Until the first show.
425-8397. And we'll
yes.
see you there
and that's
next
right
Friday
around the corner
night.
Because that's I coming know. Up.
Next week.
Friday night from
that's
Maureen
right.
McGovern. Always good to see you.
It is.
Thank
good
you.
To have
appreciate
you, Diane.
Appreciate what you're doing. Great
appreciate
job.
Appreciate everything going
great
on
great
at the
facility
NED.
In this
that's
city.
Right.
Yeah.
We love it.
All right. Well, I'm sure we'll see you several more times this season. We're going to be right back with more Six in the City.
Hi, I'm Kedrick Perkins, PGA General Manager at Jackson Country Club. Jackson Country Club's amenities are true Southern hospitality. Championship golf course, fine dining, 6 tennis courts, Junior Olympic pool and fitness. We pride ourselves in giving our members the best. Choosing JEA was a logical choice so that we could tie in our phone, internet, and cable solutions so that we can advance our next segment of technology.
In communities across Tennessee, we feel the effects of opioid addiction. We all know someone touched by addiction. People we see every day. A neighbor. A friend. A family member. Please know there is help and hope. Together we can rise above and make recovery a reality. Neighbors working together. Tennessee together. If you or someone you love needs help for addiction, help is available. Visit tntogether.com for more information.
For the most reliable drinking water supply at the highest quality, reach for the tap. Our tap water is safe and continues to exceed all government requirements. For more information about our drinking water, visit www.jacksenergy.com/JEACCR.
Move over. It's the law. When approaching work vehicles or crews, move over to create a safety zone. It protects utility workers, law enforcement, firefighters, and emergency personnel. It's not an option. Slow down. It could save a life. Stay safe. Move over.
Well, she's back. She's fussing. I've been doing all the talking during this show, so.
But you said
yeah,
you would get a chance
to talk.
Well,
I got excited because I saw you didn't
time.
Have any. You didn't have any notes.
No, I just didn't write it down.
There are no 5Ks this fall
in
West Tennessee.
That's not true. There's 5Ks. There's half marathons. There's whatever you want to do.
Whatever you want to run.
That's right. Whatever you want to run.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. There's a Labor Day 5-miler. You can
is
go 5 miles, yeah,
okay.
on Labor Day.
It's not what I had in mind for Labor Day. But
I'm
glad,
sure it's
I'm
not, but I'm just giving you an opportunity.
Okay. There's a Christmas music weekend coming up at Discovery Park this weekend for Labor Day.
Okay.
I know that's one thing going on. In
Christian
our,
music, is that what
Christian
you're
Christian music weekend. Okay. We start football Friday night.
Sure do.
Chester County at Jackson Christian, so Friday Night Live is back.
That's right, be on the lookout.
And that game will start at 7:30. Jackson Christian starting their games at 7:30. And so that'll be the telecast time.
That's right, and be on the lookout for the new EPlus TV 6 van.
Yeah, the van is out there. It's been wrapped and all that stuff.
It looks
sharp, doesn't it?
Looks very professional. You won't. It's just
the only thing that I asked for that they didn't do is put our picture on it.
I vetoed that.
Well, I mean,
you
I
can
asked,
put your picture on it. I don't want my picture on
I
it.
Went out to, I looked around at the thing twice because I'm sure I was sure I just missed it.
Carrie Brooks did a, Carrie Jones, I call her Carrie Brooks. Yeah. Carrie Jones did a great job doing the graphics on that, so it looks great. So be sure to,
yeah,
to find the truck there at the high school football games.
It's all fiber, none of us.
Which somehow is fine by me.
Somehow they consider that
it's
a priority.
It's all about the fiber. Anyway.
I know, it's all about the fiber. Anyway, we've been delighted to have these folks with us, and we're going to be doing Studio 6 with them, and it's been real. Thrill, and I've gotten used to the instrumentation now.
Yeah, you've got it down pat.
And
I know they, you want to go over there and take the cajon from Rita.
But Rita Mack, Scott Mine, and Steve Short, and best way to follow y'all is Facebook under Different Drum. And they do a lot of live work, and they're just outstanding. And so we're going to
do
close
live
this
shows.
Out.
At, y'all still doing live shows thrill. At Flatiron or the Bistro?
Bistro,
you can catch them at Bistro.
Yeah, the Bistro.
Crown Winery this weekend, right?
Crown Winery coming up this weekend. Okay.
In Humboldt. Okay.
Okay. So that'll be Friday or Saturday.
Friday
at Crown Winery.
Around town.
All right. We're going to turn it loose and let's close it out with Different Drum.
Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, blowing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place. All my memories gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, raining on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eyes, country road. Yesterday, country road.